Hello everybody, welcome to a new episode of How to DYRC. In today's episode we have the eZine E85 to show you the 5 tips you need to master to fly a drone. And starting off with choosing a flat area, and that is not the water, or even being close to the water. You should stay away, but it's almost wind quiet, it's a nice, pretty perfect day. And we have a flat surface right here in front of me. And you'll be starting with the drone facing away from you. That's the easiest way to learn to fly. It's just like sitting in the cockpit. And tip, skill number one that you need to learn is just taking off and landing. And you take off high enough so you're staying away from the ground effect that can get your drone out of balance, because there's a bubble of air there that creates unbalance. First you need to start the drone motors and then we can take off. And right here is where you don't want to be. This is right at the bubble. You want to be at least double the height of the drone to stay away from the ground effect. And the first thing is just taking off and landing again. And do it pretty fast, because in that ground effect you're having a lot of turbulent air that can tip over your drone. So it's the most difficult place to fly and the easiest place to crash. This is by taking off and landing. A nice thing about this eZine 85 altitude hill drone, they got a button for automatic takeoff and automatic landing. They're making it a lot easier, so you only have to concentrate on steering the drone at the place where it's safe to land, and you don't have to be bothered by throttling down or throttling up. Let's push that button and see what happens. Now I only have to control the drone and don't have to think about anything else. And let's land again. And while the drone is flying, you're trying to keep it in a small space, 1 by 1 meter. That is the first lesson that you have to learn, and this is the most important lesson that some people take a very long time over to learn, but that is for all for safety reasons. If you can't control your drone in a space of 1 by 1 meter, then you have no business to fly. So this is lesson number one. While you take off, stay in one place and try to land safe again. And if it's windy, you try to lean into the wind, trying to keep it in its place. You see it's drifting off, and I'm leaning a little bit to the back, because the wind is coming from that direction, pushing the drone away from me. And we're just keeping on leaning it, having it in this one small space. And if you manage that, and you manage the drift, and you're keeping it close to you, it's time to land. And now do the same, but turning the quad at least 90 degrees facing east from you. And now think about how the wind will push the quad away and how you have to lean a different direction now to keep it in that one space, 1 by 1 meter. By turning the quad, now I have to lean to the right of the quad to counterbalance the wind that is coming out of my sight. So a little bit forward and a little bit to the right. And this is where it really becomes more difficult. I have it under control, and time to land again. And we're gonna turn it facing towards you, another 90 degrees. This is where it becomes really difficult for most people, because now the left turns right, forward turns back, and the other way around. So this is the real difficult trick. So take off again, and then of course picture it in your head how you have to balance it against the wind. That's easy because it's leaning forward. And try to do this, all these 5 tip skills, low at the ground, not too high, where you have the problem if you crash, you're gonna break something. Just keep it at 1 meter height where it's safe. and it's working. And I just, again, push that button. That makes it super easy. I only have to steer the quad and don't have to think about the throttle. This is a really nice thing about an E58. Now again, you turn the quad and facing it to the west of you. And the wind picked up a little bit. And you can straight away see that the wind pushes it away, and I have to lean it towards the wind, facing it back, and keeping it in that small space, 1 by 1 meter. And you have to try this over and over and over and again until you get that muscle memory. Well, we have visitors. Let's cut to the footage and we'll be right back. Members of the public have moved on. It's now safe again to fly. So let's continue the lesson with number 3. And then we start again with having the quad facing away from you. And this time we're only going to concentrate on the right stick, on the roll, pitch, and then roll to the left, and then roll to the back, and making a big square in front of you. So press that one key, take off, making life super easy. Let's get it balanced, a little bit trimmed out. Come on, quad, trim, trim, trim. Okay, it's right there. And now we're just gonna roll to the right. Move a little bit forward. Roll to the left. Roll to the back, or pitch to the back. Then roll to the left. Then we move forward. And we go left. We go to the back. And we come back to, to the point of start. Wow, we have some geese. This is nice. Oop. Sorry for being distracted a little bit. Let's land the quad again. And now we're gonna do the same trick and turn it again 90 degrees, just like we did with the first test. And we're gonna try do the same thing as we did before, and making a square, keeping it facing to the east of us. So let's take off again. Oh. I have to trim it again a little bit. Okay. Wow. We're going forward. We're moving to the left. And then moving to the back. And then we're gonna press, leaning it into the right. Then we are coming forward again. Come on, do it slow and safe. And then lean to the left. Lean to the back. Lean to the right. Leaning forward. And stop in the middle and land safely. When you land safely, we're gonna just do as before, and now having the face, the quad towards you. And again, this is the most difficult because everything changes now. Take off. Go to the back. Oops, everything is going a little bit too fast with the wind. Put it in a little bit higher rates. Hoppa. And try to make a perfect square. And it takes a long time for a beginner to get that feeling, to get that memory, muscle memory that you need. But it is worth it, because it's really fun flying a quadcopter. And it's really different than flying a plane. Now again, we have turned the quad 90 degrees and we're gonna try again. First get the quad under control. Ooh, getting that muscle memory, because even it's getting difficult for me. Ooh. So I'm trying to make a square. Oops, but the wind is really getting annoying, and the battery is getting empty because I'm seeing the battery flashing. So, it's going a little bit too far, drifting away. But so even for me, it's a good trick to learn, because even my skills facing it to the west is a little bit difficult and I lost that muscle memory. But the battery is empty. I'm gonna put a new battery in it and then we continue with lesson number 4. I'm gonna be right back. So we have replaced the battery. It's time for lesson number 4. Now we are only going to focus on the left stick on the roll axis. And that's meaning changing the quadcopter direction completely left or completely right. So it's not leaning any direction, just like a car on 2D, left, right. And let's try that. Left, right. Whoop. It's an easy way to crash your drone and to get it lost. So be very gentle when you're putting it on the roll. Just try to do it on low rates. And let me trim it out a little bit. Alpha. Oh. And see what happens. And then do it to the right, do it to the left. And then again land until you get that feeling that you're feeling safe using the roll axis and you got that really under control, steering to the left, steering to the right, getting the control of speed that it turns, getting that real good feeling for it. Then it's really time to lesson number 5, and this is using both sticks at the same time. And this is gonna be really a new thing about for you, and this is just making a big circle around, then fly back towards you and coming back to the starting point and land. And that means that you have to facing flying it away from you, and then you have to fly it while it's facing towards you, and you have to control all skills at once. And that's the real difficult trick. So let's do a demonstration. And I show you one tip to make it really easy. When you're steering to the left, use both sticks turning to the left. You want to turn to the right, use both sticks to make it turn to the right. That is an easy hack to get it flying in a round circle. Let's perform. So we have one takeoff button, making it super easy. Getting it under control, fighting the wind, facing forward, both sticks, making it facing it towards us. Ah. On high rates because the wind is picking up. And this is with two sticks at the same time. It shouldn't be any problem just to fly around, turn around, making a circle, and just keep making circles. And stay away from the water, please. Don't ever try to fly over the water with your drone. This is not waterproof. But with two sticks at the same time, you have full control over the drone. It's super easy to fly, even when it's facing towards you. And now just easy landing, one hand, super easy drone. I really hope you're liking this series and you learned something. Hope you give it a lot of likes, of course, if this video helped you. If you're interested in this drone with altitude hold that is pretty cheap, then you'll be finding the links down below. And I hope you subscribe for in the next episode. I'm gonna show you and teach you the 5 tips you need to flying with an FPV camera for the Wi-Fi and the 5 hacks to get a pretty awesome aerial footage so you can make a nice video for YouTube. And I wanna say goodbye, until next time.